Hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk about the national feeling and the rise of imperialism. When nationalism came in Europe, it was something very good, and that brought the nations under one roof. Unification of different countries gave people a common currency, a common flag, a common national anthem, and a feeling which brought them together. But at the same time, the feeling of nationalism brought a lot of confidence amongst the nations. That confidence was to show their nations as great nations, and the spread of colonies, expansion of their empires, ultimately converted that colonialism into imperialism. And this competition of the imperialism, this competition of extending the empires, became a cause of rivalry amongst the nations. In the beginning, nationalism no longer retained after the last quarter of the 19th century. Rather, it became a competition. After 1871, the most tense area was called the Balkans. This was the area comprising of modern day. We are talking about Romania, we are talking about Bulgaria, we are talking about Albania, we are talking about Greece, we are talking about Macedonia, we are talking about Herzegovina, we are talking about Croatia, we are talking about Slovenia, we are talking about Serbia and Montenegro. So these were the nations which were the hot cake, and the cutting off different countries of Asia and Europe became one of the reasons of staunch nationalism and brought war and ultimately a disaster for the human race. Ottoman Empire, this was the Ottoman Empire region. This was explosive all through the 19th century. They strengthened themselves through modernization and internal reforms. Due to various conflicts, the Balkan became an area of intense conflict amongst different countries. During this period, intense rivalry built among the European powers over trade and colonies, as well as the naval military might, which led to a series of wars in the region and finally the First World War. This is China. China was one of the biggest nation whom different nations wanted to cut, which is known as, this intense rivalry for China is known as cutting of the Chinese melon. It was so big. In 1914, Europe was disastrous because of the nationalism aligned with the imperialism. Anti-imperial movements were developed, but they all struggled to form independent nation states. But the idea of nation states was accepted as natural and universal. The main acronym is often used to analyze the war: militarism, alliances, imperialism and nationalism brought the First World War. You can see here the expansion of Great Britain, France, Japan, United States, Netherlands, Russia, Portugal, princely states of India. So this is the way how the nationalism, staunch nationalism, was expanding the empire out of their own empires. In Africa also the same story was there. Portugal, Britain, French, Belgium, German, Spanish, Italian states were there, and these lands were subjugated by all these European powers. the rise of the next event, that is the immediate cause of the First World War, that made the aforementioned items came into play. Alliances, imperialism, militarism and nationalism made this event possible was the assassination of the Archduke Franz Ferdinand of Austria-Hungary when Russia began to mobilize due to its alliance with Serbia. Germany declared war on Russia, and this was the immediate cause of the World War One. In June 28, 1914, heir of the Austro-Hungarian throne, Archduke Franz Ferdinand and his wife are shot dead and killed while visiting Serbia. And after this event, we can see in the last page of your book, a map celebrating the British Empire. It was so big, such a big British Empire, that you can see. And many a times it was said that the sun of the British Empire never sets. In the foreground, Britannia, the symbol of the British nation, here is triumphantly sitting over the globe, the whole globe. The colonies are represented through images of the tigers, elephants, forests, and primitive people. The domination of the world is shown as the basis of the Britain's national pride. So, staunch nationalism, ultimately, European powers were there, those who wanted to subjugate maximum of the colonies, maximum of the mass, land mass, and this nationalism ultimately brought the First World War. Thank you very much.